Adam Hills, welcome to another Specky Christmas, the music quiz show that will be just like Christmas lunch. Lots of visitors, plenty of shouting, and by the end of it, you'll need to lie down. Our first team captain is a jolly, happy soul with a corncob pipe and a button nose and two eyes made out of coal. He's actor and comedian Alan Brough. Alan's first guest tonight is one of Australia's finest singers who has performed at Carols by Candlelight since 1972. Oh, really? She's as much a part of Christmas as a monogrammed hanky and two pairs of socks from Auntie Beryl. Please welcome Deborah Byrne. Oh,
thank you,
Ben. It's
Alan's final team member is a comedian whose appearances on this show have seen him fall off a desk, tackle a piano player and suggest that someone play the trumpet with their backside. Thank God he's here. He's Frank Woodley. Our second team captain had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. She's Triple J's newest addition to the breakfast show. She's Miff Warhurst. Yay! Miff's first guest tonight is back in Australia to perform her brand new stage show, Back with a Vengeance. She's a housewife, a talk show host, a megastar, and the founder and governor of Friends of the Prostate. We are honoured to be joined by the one and only Dame Edna Everidge. Miff's final guest is an English comedian who lives on a farm with two dogs, two horses, a dune buggy and a pair of Highland cows. He's two chimps and a Ferris wheel away from being Michael Jackson. Please welcome Ross Noble. Now, Dame Edna, it is a distinct pleasure to have you on the show. What does your lead up to Christmas look like this year?
Well, I'm going to be wrapping up, darlings, the biggest present I've ever given. And that is myself. I'm doing, well, what I do best, I think, a lovely stage show. And that's going to be somewhere in Melbourne. I'm trying to remember where. It's the State Theatre, the State. And I give myself in a lovely, not in a horrible way, but in a lovely way to people. And I'm so... I didn't think I'd be moved on this show. I thought I would be bored to death. I am moved.
It's a longer show than usual tonight, with more rounds, more guests, and if we're very lucky, we might even get a visit from Santa and Mrs. Claus. Oh. So let's pop this cracker with round one. Are you comfortable, Damon?
I am. We're on a beach, aren't we meant to be on a beach?
I think we're meant to be on the beach.
Sort of.
I think almost quite realistic, strange, isn't it? I hope a horrible old tsunami doesn't come along. That wouldn't be very Christmassy, would it? That'd be horrible. No, that's not laughing. That is not a laughing matter.
Let's move on, shall we? The first round of Christmas is called Know Your Product. Teams have to buzz in and answer questions on a chosen topic. Your choices tonight are Christmas music, songs for the end of the financial year, melodies of Melbourne Cup Day, and autumn equinox tunes. Miff and Alan, what do you think would be most appropriate tonight?
I enjoy having little men ride around on the top of me, so Christmas music would be good for me.
I can also take my shoes off Melbourne Cup style. So.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Well, that's quite good, because I've got crabs. You know, I mean, that's a quality item, and you've spent the money. But the slightly scary thing is you can't even see it because it's off camera, right? I'll be back in a minute.
He's being so innovative. A wombat!
A wombat! Now, that is neither Christmassy nor pleasant.
When I was a little girl, I had one of those with my Jim Jams were inside it. I had a little zip on my wombat.
Apparently, that's how you kill a wombat. You shove pyjamas.
No, no.
I've got a feeling this wombat's going to be reappearing throughout the course of the show. Whenever I don't know the answer, oh, what's that cheeky wombat? You think it's Nick Cave? Okay, then. You go down there and play with your crab, friend.
So, Miff?
We should do the right thing. We'll do Christmas music.
Christmas music it is. Everyone on your buzzers. Let's play Spicks and Specks. Your first question for 1 point. According to the Guinness Book of Records, which Christmas song is listed as the highest-selling single of all time?
Have
yes.
Yourself a...
White Christmas.
Yes, it's the Bing Crosby version of White Christmas. 1 point to kick off the show. Next question, 2 points. Have a look at this Aussie Christmas song by Painters and Dockers. I need you to work out two things. The next word of the song, which is a girl's name, and the Australian capital city in which the film clip was shot. So merry, 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 merry Christmas. Yes.
I don't know. I think we can have a guess, though, can't we?
Hobart.
Okay, and what was the next word in the song?
Mary.
So you're saying Mary?
Did we just say Mary, 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 Mary?
Is it Mary, 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 Christmas?
Mary.
I'm afraid it was neither Hobart nor Mary. So I'm going to open it up to the other team if you want to have a guess.
I would guess Melbourne.
I saw a wreckage, which would place us in Melbourne.
Okay, that's another. And the name, Mary, Mary, Merry Christmas. I think it's
Kylie.
Mary as well.
It is shot in Melbourne, so I'll give you a point for that. Let's have a look, see what the next word was.
Merry, Merry Christmas. Carol.
Carol.
Christmas Carol.
Merry Christmas Carol.
But it looked Tasmanian, didn't it?
It did. For 3 points, name three Christmas songs with the word bells in the title.
Jingle Bells.
Jingle Bells is one.
Jingle Bell Rock.
Jingle I can't accept that because I need the word bells, plural, in the title, I'm afraid.
Christmas bells.
Yes, that's another one. So it means you've got 2 out of 3. I'll open it up to the other team.
Hell's Bells.
I don't think Hell's Bells was particularly a Christmas song.
It is of a Satanist family.
How about Silver Bells?
Oh, God.
Silver bells.
And then other words after Silver Bells.
I would have also accepted the Bells of Christmas, Carol of the Bells, and Christmas Time, Don't Let the Bells End by the Darkness. Final question worth 4 points. The seldom-sung first verse of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer lists the original 8 reindeer, including Dasher, Prancer, Comet, and Donner, also known as Donder. Name the other 4.
Blitzen.
Yep.
Prancer.
Prancer.
Dancer.
Romancer.
Necromancer.
You've got Blitzen and Dancer. I'm going to open it up to this team.
Farlap.
What?
The other two were, I think the audience knew, Vixen and Cupid. Oh. At the end of that round, the scores are Alan, Dev and Frank were on 2 points. Myth, Dame Edna and Ross in the lead, 4 points. The second round of Christmas is called Look What They've Done to My Song, Ma. We're going to play some Christmas tunes while teams have to buzz in if you know the name of the song. And in keeping with the summer Christmas theme, tonight the tunes will be played by members of the surf band The Reefers. Please welcome The Reefers to the show. Teams, hands on your buzzers. Reefers, first song, please. So you're on the right song.
Stop it! Thank you very much.
What was that, Deb?
Winter Wonderland.
Winter Wonderland it was.
The thing that disconcerted me was when the wombat appeared again, something suggested about the ears. I was getting a bit of Chopper Reed there.
I would just like to say that I will not make jokes about Chopper Reed on television. He's a lovely man, and this wombat doesn't resemble him in any way. All letters should be addressed to Mr. Frank Woodley over there.
Right, let's move on with song two. Hands on buzzers, teams. Okay. Go for it, Reefers.
Thank you.
Have Yourself a Merry Christmas.
Have Yourself a Merry Little Christmas. Well done, Viv.
I've got to say, though, with the caravan and these guys looking the way they are, which is mighty fine, they're bringing me the vibe of Torquay Caravan Park circa 1979, and I'm loving it. Thank you very much.
All right, final song, please, Reefers. Joy to the world. You did get it right, Fred.
He was right.
It's the first time I've ever actually answered a question right. I went, joy to the world. And Deborah went, no, no. It's not.
I have issues.
But isn't it funny to think that if those songs had been originally played like that, they'd never have been popular.
True.
All right, at the end of that round, the scores are... Oh, Alan, Deb and Frank did make a comeback to 4 points, but Miff, Dame Edna and Ross are still in the lead with 5 points. Right, the third round of Christmas is called Something's Missing. I'm going to show each team an album cover with a word or an item blanked out. You have to tell me what is missing from that cover. Alan, Deborah and Frank, you're up first. Here is your album. It is Christmas with... whom?
So it's a person. It's not. It couldn't just be Christmas with eczema.
Or along those lines, Christmas with the Witness Protection Program.
Hang on, there's a little clue. You can see a little bit of the hand there.
Yeah. Yes, it's dark. Could be
Christmas with Colin Powell.
Ooh. Christmas with Colin Powell. Can you imagine that? Yeah, we know where Christmas is hidden. Well, actually, we don't.
I'll give you a clue.
Okay.
It's a large bucket-shaped present.
What a bucket shaped other than buckets?
Yeah.
Like a knight's helmet that's turned upside down.
Ned Kelly. Christmas with Ned Kelly.
Let's have a look, shall we? Christmas with Colonel Sanders.
I think we should get half a point because you misled us with your clue because you said a bucket shaped item. Mm.
What you should have said was, and that thing's a Colonel Sanders ship.
That would have made a lot of sense.
Right, Miff, Dame Edna and Ross, here is your first album cover. It's a blank Christmas for the family.
Chainsaw?
Is it, Molly, the little boy looks like he's got sort of, is he got his mouth open going,
I can hardly see it. Yes, I'd wish I had lenses in these glasses.
Your clue is to have a look at the way the children are dressed.
They're dressed in red.
A communist Christmas
thing. They sort of look 50s or 60s, don't they? What would have been a popular gift in the 60s?
In the 60s? How would I know, darling?
Oh, of course.
No, I would have thought a drug of some kind.
Is it Hammond organ? Is it Hammond?
Oh no, have a knitted Christmas.
Have a macrame Christmas.
One of those Ronco knitting devices.
Knitting machine.
Have a Ronco Christmas.
We'll go with that.
Ronco?
That's the best. Have
a knitted
knitting.
Christmas.
This knitting. Have a knitting Christmas.
It's got to be a knitting machine.
Let's have a look.
Come on.
It's a singer. It's a singer sewing machine.
So close.
You were so close. Alan, Deborah, and Frank, here is your second album. It's Have a Blank Christmas. What is missing from the title?
Well, I like that it's a question. Have a blank Christmas?
Yeah, what's it mean? Right. Mm.
Yeah,
have a blank Christmas.
Have a pointy Christmas?
What is
have
that?
Have an isosceles Christmas?
It looks to me like Mr. Mr. Man who's like Santa Claus, Mr. Man who's also living in a pyramid. So I reckon it's
Have, a Mr.
have yourself
Christmas?
A very happy Egyptian Mr. Man. Santa Christmas.
I'll give you a clue. That's not actually a Christmas tree. There are some things that we've blanked out around the outside of it.
Right. Good.
No, I'm sorry. I've got absolutely. I have no idea what that is.
Let's have a look. A Jewish Christmas. I have no idea how that works.
I'd like to hear the songs on that one.
And by the way, that album came from Mel Gibson's personal collection. Niff, Dame Edna and Ross, here is your final album cover. There are three words blanked out from this. The artist is called RuPaul. What are those three words?
Mine are bigger.
It's got to be three wise ladies.
I'll tell you what, your clue is, say what you see.
Little bit sus.
Three white boobies. No, four, aren't there?
Six.
No, six.
Six.
Yeah. Glass.
What is your final answer?
Three wise ladies.
Three wise lady boys.
Let's have a look.
Oh, nice.
Because she's so happy.
Yeah. It was a Christmas album released by a drag singer, which is just like a normal Christmas album, but the jingle bells have been removed. At the end of that round, the scores are Alan, Deb and Frank still on 4 points, Miff, Dame Edna and Ross still on 5 points.
Just before we go on, can I just say that being situated underneath these, it feels like sitting under a very festive King Kong.
You know, darling, jokes of that kind occurred to all of us.
The fourth round of Christmas is called So Mix and Match a Lot, and for this, we're going to need some little helpers. Santa has kindly lent us a couple of his elves tonight, so would you please give a specky round of applause for singer, songwriter and elf number one, Ella Hooper. Hello, Ella. Has Santa been keeping you busy?
Very busy. We've been rushed off our feet. Was that good?
What have you been doing for Sam?
Well, you know, he's pretty picky. We've been preparing the backstage area, getting his rider sorted out. Yeah, we had to import the snow from Colombia, get the green and the red M&Ms out of the packets and...
Since when Santa David Lee Roth?
We should introduce your second assistant. It's comedian, radio announcer and elf number two, Dave O'Neill.
I think someone's meant to say, thank God you're here.
Thank God you work on radio.
Thank you, I like it. I've got other jobs. I've been down to Pixie Photos freaking the kids out.
I don't mean to ruin the spirit of Christmas, but I think your ears are the wrong way around.
Yeah. John Howard's IR laws are hitting us bad.
Yeah. We can't put new ears that go on the right way.
We have to work on Christmas Day. We're not even getting double time, you know?
No. Yeah, but you have the rest of the year off.
Oh, no, we do Easter as well. And she's the tooth fairy. And I'm the Hamburglar.
All right, well, that's... Now, each team will be given three artists and three interesting facts. You have to match the artist to the fact. Now, tonight, you have to match three live musicians with the presents they'll be receiving for Christmas. Dave and Ella, could you bring out our musicians, please?
Sure.
For Alan, Deborah and Frank, first up.
Your first guest tonight is the winner of Opportunity Oz, David Parkin. Your second artist is Australian Idol winner, Damien Leith. And your final guest is the winner of episode 79 of Spicks and Specks, Rebecca Barnard.
Alan, Deborah, Frank, you have to match these guys with the presents they will be receiving this Christmas, which are a water tank, a romantic weekend getaway, and a money belt. You're allowed one question to each of these lucky present receivers, so fire away, ask them a question, see if you can work out what they are actually getting for Christmas.
Deb, you ask a question first.
Well, you know, Rebecca, you're a winner, and so...
Apparently.
But as a singer, do you find you need sort of... constant lubrication? I mean, do you suffer of dehydration or possibly like personal irrigation problems? I don't know.
Yeah, I suffer from dehydration.
Okay.
Okay. Which is my own fault.
Right, but not enough liquid, probably.
Probably liquid of the wrong sort.
Right.
I'm getting a bit of a feeling about the weekend away for Damien because You need to relax so you can sing so beautifully, because you've got that beautiful falsetto voice. It's so beautiful, it's practically a real setto. That I think you need to relax with... So, do you find that you sing better if you're very, very relaxed?
Oh, yeah, you know, I got to be totally laid back, totally relaxed, you know, the more stressed I am, the higher my voice gets.
David, just a very simple question. When you visit a nudist colony... do you find it difficult to find somewhere to put your money?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Clearly, if David, if you whacked a couple of $10 notes into that and then wore it while you were performing, you could say that you appeared on stage with the three tenors.
Okay, we have to make a decision. What's our decision going to be? I think Rebecca and the extremely small water tank.
With the massive, rather large tap. Yeah.
And then I think Damien with the weekend away.
You think Damien with the weekend away?
There's
a lot of money.
You want to go with that? All right, open up, find out what you're getting for Christmas. One, two, three.
Oh, we
go. Go, open it, yeah.
Ooh.
Nice. Some money, man. Nice.
Three out of three. David Parkin is getting the money belt. Damien Leith will be having a romantic weekend getaway. Sadly, it's only for one. And Rebecca Barnard is getting the romantic water tank.
Yeah.
3 points out of three. Well done, Alan, Deborah, Frank. Please thank Rebecca Barnard, David Parkin and Damien Leith. Miff, Dame Edna and Ross, let's meet your musicians. Take it away, Elf Ella.
Your first guest is legendary vaudeville performer Val Gelay.
Yay!
Party is?
Yes, that's it. That's it.
That's all going on. This is exciting.
It's my 21st. So.
You have my hairstyle.
Did you have yours before me?
I was born with this.
And beautiful it is.
And you're gorgeous, Val.
And you're a perfectionist.
Thrilled to see you.
My pleasure.
What colour do you call your hair, Val?
Two-tone.
Is it?
Yes.
Mine's jacaranda.
Next up, from the Cat Empire, it's part-time Macy Gray impersonator and full-time trumpeter Harry Angus.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, come on, Harry. Come on, come on. Come on. Yeah. Thank you, Will. Good to see you dressed up anyway.
Your final musician is from the 70s band that rocked the house at the Countdown Spectacular. From Hush, it's Les Gock.
Yay!
Come on, Les. Hi, gang.
Once again, Miff, Dame Edna and Ross, you have to match these people with the presents they will be receiving for Christmas this year, which are a GPS system for a car, a kimono, and the original orchestral arrangement of the John Williams score for the movie Star Wars.
Les,
yes.
In the 70s, you found your way around some very tight pants. I've seen the footage in the 70s. Lots
you
of jumpsuits
that closely?
And that kind of thing. Yeah, yeah. How do you find your way around on the roads? Are you a good navigator?
I was the worst. Every time we just went into a town, a country town, they all looked the same to me. But I knew how to find my pants, though. And what was in them?
A cucumber wrapped in tinfoil.
How do these guys know so much?
I don't know. Yeah. We do that in Elfland too.
I wish that elf would stop interrupting. Harry, darling, I love watching wind instrument players emptying the dribble out of the Do you get much? Half a bucket? A bucket?
I actually got an email recently accusing me of something I never realised I did, but of kind of doing these grandiose gestures with my trumpet, kind of like this.
Oh.
And just spraying the crowd. So I apologise.
Rudolph doesn't have his tail.
I was there's that elf again. You know that character, Darth Vader? Have you heard of him?
Mm. Yeah. Yeah, I've heard of him.
Did Darth Vader have a little tap like a trumpet where the dribble came out? Dun, 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 dun. Oh, that reminds me, I must get me Nan a Christmas present. Anyway, Val, have you ever, on the sly, done a bit of cheeky secret guess you were.
If it's got anything to do with travelling, forget it. I get seasick on a damp lawn.
I'll bring my nan round, you'll know about damp lawns.
Well, what are we going to go with?
I think I'm lovely for that boy in the middle. I would have thought the soundtrack of Star Wars would be a lovely gift for you.
I agree.
That's my guess.
Yeah. You're saying that present stays exactly where it is? It
stays there in the middle.
And the GPS there?
GPS for Les.
And you're saying that Val is getting the kimono, is that correct?
Yes.
Oh, all right, so. Guys, open your presents.
A GPS navigation system!
That's right, Val is receiving the original orchestral arrangement of John Williams' Star Wars.
Just what I've always wanted!
Harry Angus is receiving the kimono, and Les is receiving the GPS, which stands for Gok Positioning System. Would you please thank Les Gok, Val Gillet, and Harry Angus? At the end of that round, the scores are Mifto, Medna and Ross are on 6 points, but Al and Deborah and Frank have made it into the lead with 7 points. Whoa. Hang on.
Oh, here we go.
That must mean someone's here. Oh. Mrs. Claus is here.
Oh, thank you.
Oh,
so great to see you, and just great to be in a brand new outfit for this Christmas. Feeling such a visual treat. I am. Hello, David. Hello, darling. You've been working so hard in the workshop. It's so hard to make iPods. Anyway, can I get a bit political?
You can.
They are banning, you're going to find this unbelievable, banning Santa from appearing at preschools because of cultural reasons. Now, I want to know what these people are thinking. Are they thinking that some little Muslim kid is going to see a big, fat, hairy man sitting in the corner of his kinder and he's going to freak out and run away and cry and hide? Of course he is. It's nothing to do with his religion. It's because he's terrified, just like the Christian children. And I think, therefore, Santa brings children of all creeds and all colours together to share the common experience of terror. No, you don't want to sit on that fat old man's knee, but if that is what it's going to take to get your little Bob the Builder set, you bloody well do it. It's a great Australian tradition. This is for Ella. All the best wishes for your hard work. And Dave...
Shut up, David.
Of course, David. Dave, I've got a lovely pudding for you. We'll bring it on now.
Oh, lovely.
Just bring on the pudding now. It'll help us.
You know the best thing about this? That fat bastard Santa isn't here, so I have to share it with him. Neil!
Santa's here! Mrs. Claus, it's lovely to have you here. Would you like... Santa looks a little bit wobbly.
Santa.
Come out of your cape hole. Here we go. Come on, Mother.
Oh, yes. There's just something weird, isn't there, about the chemistry between us.
It is. It's a tasty pudding. Is this a plum pudding?
I believe it's a sticky date.
My favourite.
Now, Santa and Mrs. Claus, how has your year been? Have you been busy?
I've been hungry. I've got crumbs in my beard.
I feel like I am your beard.
Let's move on, shall we? The fifth round of Christmas is called Please, Please Tell Me Now. Both teams will be shown part of a film clip. You will then have to answer questions about that clip. Now, your clip tonight is Jingle Bell Rock by the 80s duo Hall & Oates.
Oh, lovely.
Nice. Oh, yes. And I must warn you, this is probably one of the edgier Christmas video clips you will ever see. Let's have a look. There will be a test afterwards.
Oh, look at those hands.
Look at that walk.
It's just ridiculous, isn't it?
Jingle bell, jingle bell, jingle bell rock. That's John Oates.
I looked like Borat to me.
Yes.
Some guests coming in.
It's a strange little film, isn't it?
It's very odd.
It's a bit like a commercial for gay marriage, I think. Yes.
Your first question. What is in Daryl Hall's shirt pocket? Yes?
Some mistletoe, holly, foliage of some description.
Let's have a look. I'd say that's foliage.
Yep.
Nice. That's definitely foliage. Well done. A point. Your second question. What colour is the wrapping on the top present?
Who pushed that?
Oh, no, I did. It's my fault. I went off too early. it's silver.
All right, let's have a look. It's silver. Oh, silver is right at the top. Next question. With which hand does John Oates listen to his present?
The right hand.
The right hand?
Yeah.
Let's look. No, that's the left hand.
That'd be one of the two, didn't it?
Your next question, true or false? There is an angel on top of the tree.
False.
False? Let's look. False, it's a star. Well done, Dan.
And not many people know, but that star went on to be a photo model for the Jewish Christmas album.
Your next question. How many people are not allowed into the house?
Three,
says Deb. Let's look. Three people. Well done, Deb.
On fire!
Your final question. What is in the guitar-shaped present?
A bucket. You're not catching us out like that again.
I'm actually scared.
Why are you scared?
That sounds like a trick question.
What are you going to say, Dad?
No. Trust your instincts.
Yeah, just feel the force.
Guitar.
Of course it was a guitar. Yes, well played. At the end of that round, the scores are Miff, Dave, Edna and Ross on 7 points. Alan, Deb and Frank way out in front now. 11 points. The sixth round of Christmas is called Mistletoss. Santa needs some help putting some presents in a few special stockings that are hanging over the fireplace. Each stocking belongs to a different musician and is worth a different value. Bono from U2 is only worth 1 point because he's already got everything. Madonna is worth 2 points. If you can get a present in for Britney, you get 3 points. Keith Urban is worth 4 points, but you have to promise to keep him away from the eggnog. And the little stocking all the way down there belongs to Anthony Kalia. Oh. Now, Dame Edna, I understand you know some of these people.
I know all of them.
Do you?
But that won't stop me giving them a nice present.
What have you picked out?
I think Brittany some little panties. Don't you think that's a good idea? Yes.
She hasn't been wearing hers of late,
so
has she?
So she can get out of a car and look a little more respectful.
That's right. Keith.
I give him a night with Nicole Kidman. Wouldn't that be nice? I'll ring up his facility. And I'll guarantee him. I'll have him sprung, the darling.
What are you getting this year?
I want a little person called Wawa. The reason I want Wawa, quite frankly, is I'm sick of turkey. I'm...
Santa, have you got any presents tucked away over there?
It's a bit of a mistake. I was going to give Madonna a Malawian baby, but I accidentally wrapped Anthony Kalia. Pop him in there anyway.
Miff, Dame Edna and Ross, if you'd like to make your way to the fireplace, please.
What does MIP stand for, darling?
Mifanwi.
M-Y-F. I think it stands for my young friend.
Right, your line's there. You have to stand behind it. You have 30 seconds to get as many presents as you can in the stockings. Your time starts now.
Go.
This one.
Oh, my God.
But I think I've ruptured my armpit. Right. I'm used to throwing gladdies. I can't throw these.
Elves, what was the tally?
10, I believe it was 10 points.
10 points. Alan, Deborah and Frank, you're up next. Would you like to make your way down?
Yeah. Yeah.
Once again, you have 30 seconds on the clock. Your time starts now. Oh, it's not going well.
I've got to get on to this side.
Oh, what the fuck? Oh, I can't get anything in Britney's sack.
We have some more. Hands up!
Thank you, Mother!
Elves, that was the tally.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
It's yes! 9. Well done. 9 points. Alan, Deb, and Frank. Well, are you happy with that, Frank?
Yes, I thought I might. I felt like I threw like a girl, but it was Lauren Jackson. So it worked.
And now, Frank, you have a very special present that you once received for Christmas.
When I was 6, I got, like, this little pair of purple jocks that had pictures of monkeys and stars on them.
And you loved them.
But I reckon if it had just pictures of monkeys on them, I probably would have liked them. And if it had pictures of stars on them, I would have liked them. But monkeys and stars, I'm still wearing those jocks. No, but I really just love those jocks.
Was it like when the Russians sent monkeys into space? Was that like depicting the experiment in pants form? Because the monkeys never come back, so at some point they must have pulled the ejector button and just floated off.
Yeah. Thanks, Ross. That's my most beautiful little childhood image. And those monkeys were actually slowly suffocating.
No, they were...
What monkeys are you talking about now?
Yeah. After that round, the scores are Miff, Dame Edna and Ross are catching up. They're on 17 points. Alan, Deb and Frank still in front, though, 20 points. The seventh round of Christmas is a slightly different version of Substitute. To help us out, would you please welcome ABC Classic FM Victorian Choir of the Year Concordus and their two conductors, comedians Scott Edgar and Michelle Lawrence. Tonight, Concordus will be singing well-known Christmas songs using the words of an unrelated piece of text. Each team has to identify the Christmas song they are singing. Now, tonight, the lyrics will be drawn from the highs and lows of 2006. Michelle, you'll be conducting first for Alan, Deborah and Frank. Which text will you be using?
Well, Adam, what could be more festive than quotes from former head of US Defence, Donald Rumsfeld?
Fantastic. Take it away, Michelle.
Okay, ready? And eyes up. And smile for Mummy. Ready for your note? And on four counts of eight, and eight, 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 eight.
No messages that there are no knowns, there are things that we know that we know. There are known unknowns, that is to say, there are things that we now know we don't know. But there are also unknown unknowns, there are things we don't know. And each year we discover a few more of those unknown unknowns.
What was that song?
I believe that song is Jingle Bells.
That song was indeed Jingle Bells.
Oh, wow.
Well done.
All right, Scott, over to you. You'll be conducting for Miff, Dame Edna and Ross. What will you be taking your words from?
Well, Adam, we take as our text for this piece, a very important piece of television, speaking of recently retired people, this is a speech by Naomi Robson, and she... she in this is talking about her recent trip to Papua to save... Wah wah.
I've been buried and endured. Personal tax over this story. I love going to night has been heard. For the peace that's lost to the sight of the real story. Here's the story of wah 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 wah.
Thank you.
Ding Dong Very Loud and High.
It was Ding Dong Really Loud High. Well spotted. Back to you, Michelle. What's your text for your next song?
Well, the ABC, Adam, has become very, very concerned about the issue of bias. And honestly, Adam, I'm just being honest, I've always felt that Spicks and Specks was a little bit too pro-Spicks and Specks. So we've based our next item on just some of the very many complaints that have been lodged with the ABC about your show.
O Come All You Faithful is exactly the song they were doing. Well done. Scott, what are you going to sing from next?
Well, look, this one is from a very recent, very devastating... I personally lost a lot of faith when this happened. This is from transcripts of the reason why Paul McCartney and Heather Mills got divorced. So, we ready?
So Paul continued to use illegal drugs and to drink excessively. He tried to prevent her breastfeeding, saying they are mine. Mills canceled an operation because it interfered with his holiday plans. Objected to her buying an antique bedpan to save her crawling to the toilet last night.
What was that song?
A Good King Wenceslas.
It indeed was Good King Wenceslas. Well spotted. Michelle, your final song, what text are you using?
Oh, well, this year, Adam, Eddie Maguire added a whole new meaning to the word boned to our vocabulary when his private conversations were leaked to the media. So we've taken a transcript of one of those conversations and we've created item three.
What are we going to do about Jessica? Are you sure you want to get rid of her?
Quite sure, thank you.
She is a loving stock, and if we keep her on air, we'll be the loving stock. Should we board her? I reckon it should be next week.
That'd be him.
Little drama boy. No, a little drama boy. Oh, no, it's Christmas! Oh, I haven't got anything for Mum! The little drama boy, on the other hand, much more calm.
It was a little drama boy. Finally, for Miftah, Medna and Ross, take us home, Scott.
OK, well, I shall be conducting the entire choir for this last one, which I think you'll find is a little bit of a climax. And it's from a very devastating piece of Australian history that happened this year, of course. It's from transcripts of the commentary of the World Cup game, Australia versus the filthy Italians. take it away.
Is it behind Marco Bresciano? Fabio Grosso, Fabio Grosso, it's a penalty, it's a penalty. Oh, it's a disaster for Australia.
The Hallelujah Chorus. Well done. 3 points for both teams. But ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for Michelle Laurie, Scott Edgar, and Concordis. After that round, the scores are Miff, Dame Edna, and Ross are on 20 points. Alan, Deb, and Frank only just in front. 23 points. The last round of Christmas is the final countdown. Teams, hands on your buzzers. 1 point for a correct answer, 1 point off for a wrong answer. Your questions start now. What do Dido, Annie Lennox, and supposedly Jesus Christ have in common?
They were all born on Christmas.
They were all born on Christmas Day. Well done, Ross.
Well done.
Do They Know It's Christmas was re-recorded in 1989 by Band Aid 2, produced by Stock, Aitken and Waterman. Which two Australian pop stars...
Kylie and Jason.
Jason Donovan, Kylie Minogue. Well done, Ross. The musical of which Dr. Seuss book opened on Broadway last month?
You'd think it was The Grinch, wouldn't you? Because we're on a Christmas show. Yeah. The Grinch?
How the Grinch Stole Christmas. Well done, Al.
Love you.
According to the title of their 1956 song, what did the Goons do for Christmas?
Walk backwards.
Walk backwards, noble. Yeah. According to the song, where did Mummy kiss Santa Claus?
Underneath the mistletoe.
It was underneath the mistletoe. Well done, Al.
Thinking of part
body part. Oh, yeah.
Who released the album Rocky Mountain Christmas in 1975?
John Denver.
It was John Denver. True or false, there is a song on that album entitled Please, Daddy, Don't Get Drunk This Christmas.
True.
True. Complete these Christmas song titles. Oh, Little Town of...
Bethlehem.
Bethlehem, I'm afraid these guys got in first.
I thought it was Geelong. And you'd be lucky to find a virgin there as well. I'm joking. I've told you, the good people of Geelong won't like that one. Or three wise men, but I didn't say that. I'm joking, I swear to God.
It came upon a midnight... Yes?
Cowboy.
Clear. I'm right here.
Clear. It was clear. Well done. All I want for Christmas is my... Wow, they're quick on this side.
Two front teeth.
And complete this one. C-H-R-I-S-T-M-A...
Yes.
Yes. Your final question. What is the total number of presents my true love sent to me on its 12th day?
Fudding!
No.
No, I didn't think so.
No, it's not. I'm going to keep it open until someone gets it at this point. First team to get it.
56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 80, 81, 82, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 89, 90, 91.
The Wombat has an answer. Oh, no, it just says, help, I'm no good at math.
70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78.
78!
Say, Meghna, did you think when you came on there'd be a man sitting next to you with a wombat and another man opposite you just yelling numbers?
I never thought our marsupials would be ridiculed to the extent that you...
I've not ridiculed them. I've made them my friend. I've tamed them. And unfortunately, in the excitement, I've ripped his head off. But that's an excellent Christmas gift. Place a pen in there, you know, for somebody that, say, works in an office. Just stick it in there, like that. Where's my pen?
It's in me wombat now.
At the end of another Specky Christmas, the final scores were Miff, Dame Edna and Ross managed 26 points, but Alan, Deborah and Frank won the day with 31 points.
What?
I think I
was
looking
under our shoulders. Yeah. I feel like you should do it.
And Deborah.
Oh, I can't tell you how good I'm doing.
You've never won an episode of Spicks and Specks. Yeah. This was your Christmas miracle.
It is, isn't it?
Would you please thank our guests for tonight? Deborah Byrne, Frank Woodley, Dame Edna Everidge, and Ross Noble. And Harry the Cheeky Wombat. Would you also please thank, of course, our two team captains, Alan Brough and Miff Warhurst.
Yeah.
And can we have a huge round of applause for our elves, Dave O'Neill and Ella Hooper, for Santa and Mrs. Claus, and for all our special guests that dropped by tonight. Now, it wouldn't be Christmas if we didn't fire up the Barbie, gather a choir together and leave you with a good old family sing-along. And tonight, I'd like to dedicate a special Christmas carol to my Nana. Many years ago, as a family, we sat round, the Hills family sat round watching Carols by Candlelight. I reckon you were probably on it, Deb.
I may have been.
We were seated there together, and Ray Martin appeared and said, coming up after the break, we'll have that classic Christmas carol, Deck the Halls. And my Nana's hearing wasn't too good. And she looked at us and went, oh, I've never heard that one. We went, I beg your pardon? She said, that's a new one? And, no, I don't think so, Nana. We sing it every year. And she went, what? Dick the Horse. So, as a tribute to her, I'd like to finish the show tonight, if you don't mind, by singing Dick the Horse for my grandmother. And I'm not that great a singer, so Dame Edna, would you do me the honour of accompanying me on the tra-la-la-la-las?
I'd love to help you.
Excellent. Let's make our way down to the front of the stage.
Eats lots of lollies. That's the way he gets his jollies. This is how my Nana heard it. Now we sing it every Christmas. Lots of lollies.
La, 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 la.
That's the way he gets his jollies. This is how my Nana heard it. Now we sing it every Christmas.
On behalf of everyone here at Spicks and Specks, Merry Christmas, Australia.